Here with me is Professor Stefan Ullebroek, Vice Rector, Academic and Student Affairs of UNESCO IG, and one of the representatives during the Budapest Water Summit. I would like to ask, in what way was education as a topic integrated in the sessions of the Budapest Water Summit?
Well, thanks. Overall, the importance of education is very clear to everybody. Everybody agrees that this is key education capacity development. And therefore, it also had a prominent role at the Budapest Water Summit. However, there was not our own session on education only. So there were aspects of education were integrated into a number of different sessions in the different fora, the Science Forum in particular. And the overall importance of education was repeatedly stated also in a number of the panel discussions. But there was not a whole theme only on education, yes.
But it was integrated in one of the sessions that you participated in, which was about water governments. How was it integrated in that session?
Yeah, well, there were three keynote speakers, and I was one of the three speakers giving a keynote on the importance of education and what do all the global changes, what do the SDGs, what does that mean for education? Do we need to change our educational approaches? Where do we have to adapt? That was my presentation about. Well, maybe I try to put it into the perspective of illustrating how important it is to have education really at the forefront. This is for a number of reasons. One is that we have already now not enough trained professionals to deal with the water challenges. But if you look at the global changes that are currently ongoing, including climate change, urbanization, other land use changes, the IT development, the challenges connected to the green economy that we need for the future, we really have to rethink the way we educate, and therefore the dimensions for education really need to be discussed and put on the forefront. Yeah.
And also the complexity of the water-related issue is also a reason why education should be reconsidered, right?
Yes, I couldn't agree more. Also, if you see challenges in the professional sector, well, my presentation was mainly about the training of individuals. It was less about capacity building of the organizational sector or institutional dimension to capacity building. So it was really training about talking about degree programs, training of professionals. And there, one challenge is that there's a graying of the professional society. There's people getting older and older, people in public services responsible for water management. The percentage of professionals above 50 is already very large, and it's getting larger. That means that in a short period of time, many of them will retire, and we will lose them. And with that, maybe a lot of tacit knowledge. Therefore, we really need to improve our educational setups. And overall, even with the current people involved in water management in the wider sense, we have too few professions anyway, and there's a huge gap of capacity to deal with the current problems, in particular in Africa, Asia, and Latin America. But this gap will only increase in the future if we do not put it more up front.
And what is your personal view on how education in combination with capacity development should be implemented in the SDGs?
Well, it's an open-ended process at the moment, the SDGs. What I think there's a lot of consensus when it's about that there should be one water SDG. I think that's on the horizon. Of course, we don't know the outcome of the open working group at this moment, but at least the water professionals seem all to agree on that. Was repeatedly stated last week. They all seem to agree on that, the importance of having one SDG only focusing on water. That SDG should be wider in terms of concentrating on water supply and sanitation, but also the wider water resources problems and issues should be connected to that. And I strongly feel that then also disaster and disaster management should be part of it, but then also education and capacity building. And we should have very firm targets related to that, because all the other activities, is it in the wash sector, water supply, sanitation, hygiene, is it in the wider water resources sector and conflicts about water resources, is it in the disaster management and prevention, without trained professionals, any target cannot be reached. So therefore, we should also have very ambitious and firm targets related to education and capacity building.